this main event and we want to welcome the challenger, Jaime Munguia and his team, Fernando Beltran and Oscar De La Hoya. Yes, they are all coming up, Bernard Hopkins as well. So it was certainly a valiant effort from Jaime Munguia, the former world champion. He has nothing to hang his head about on losing to Canelo Alvarez by a unanimous decision. It was incredible atmosphere here as a referee. Sold out here, T-Mobile Arena, and as we are now set, we are going to open things up first to Jaime and to just talk about, you know, come up short, suffering your first loss to Canelo Alvarez. Just early first thoughts on this fight. So we just want to get your first early thoughts, Jaime, on, you know, the difficult loss, the valiant effort, and you really left it all in the ring. Just discuss first thoughts on, you know, the loss.
Mira por mira, ¿qué tanto aprendiste esta noche
¿Y qué tanto te motiva todo lo que asimilaste para en un futuro tú ser el rostro de la opción mundial?
Well, the question is, in 2013, Canelo Alvarez fought Floyd Mayweather and he lost the fight. Yeah, after that, he was a face of boxing. What do you, this motivates you to be right after the face of boxing?
Sí, así es, la verdad, creo que voy a seguir trabajando fuerte. Creo que es una buena experiencia, la verdad, creo que empecé muy bien, empezó a ganar buena experiencia, pero la verdad que, bueno, pues,
yes, it's a great experience, and honestly, I started very good, very good. I was feeling very good, and then he started beating me with his good experience. But honestly, I started very good.
Straight back, guys. All the way back here. Did you ask Jaime, when you got knocked out with the uppercut, how hurt were you? Did you feel like that changed the fight? Because it seemed like he really got into a groove after that, after taking your early incoming, and the knockdown really got him going, and from there on he sort of took over the fight.
Sí, así es. La verdad que nunca, cuando me colgó el hombre, la verdad nunca me sentí lastimado. Más que nada me sorprendió. Pero lastimado, la verdad que no estaba.
Honestly, when he hit me with the uppercut, I was more surprised than hurt. I was surprised, and I was not hurt, and he was in punch. Canelo Alvarez surprised you with his condition in the last rounds, with everything that he did in the last rounds, and do you think he will give you another shot?
Bueno, yo creo que, como te digo, empecé muy bien la pelea, empecé ganando, creo que los primeros 3, 4 rounds, después de ahí, él, pues, me empecé a meter en su pelea, empecé a jugar, empecé a quedar puesto en su juego.
He was in a great shape, he was in a great condition, and honestly, I was winning the first rounds, and he, after the knockdown, I started to fall into his aim, and he started to be doing his spirit.
Hola Jaime, ¿cómo estás? Buenas noches de este lado. Acá Jaime de este lado. Enrique Beas, buenas noches, un saludarte. Oye Jaime, escuchando un poco toda cómo articulas a partir de este momento lo que pasó esta noche, a mí se me gustaría saber, después de que tenías los primeros 3, 4 rounds, tu percepción de algo muy claro que además todo el mundo debate, sobre todo en México. Saúl Canelo Álvarez es invencible, es el mejor.
My question is that you were beating him in the first round, and do you think that Saúl Canelo Álvarez is unbeatable, is invincible?
Bueno, pues no lo pienso así. Obviamente es súper bueno, pero ya tiene dos tres perdidas, entonces eso quiere decir que es imposible, pero es
súper peligroso. No, I don't think he's invincible. He already got 2 losses, and I think he's a very good fighter, but I don't think he's invincible.
Two more questions, guys. Two more questions.
Thank you. Gonzalo Alvarado, gracias en español y World Sports. Primero que nada, felicidades por esta noche, tu desempeño impresionante. Congratulations on the performance, you're amazing. Después del cuarto round, cuando caíste en la lona, ¿qué percepción cambió en tu forma de pelear más una década adelante? When you, were knocked out of the fourth round, did your perception change in some way to keep you focused?
Bueno, yo creo que tal vez siento que tal vez necesito un poco por recuperar los puntos y ir a buscar la pelea y ejecutar, y cuando pues, él aprovechó y pelear y se empezó a ganar.
No, I think I get desperate to try to recover that knockdown, and I start changing my game. And I think with his experience, he start getting into his game with the counter punch.
Yo vi a Jaime Munguía muy bien, lo hizo muy bien, peleó contra la cara del boxeo. Y para ir 12 asaltos con la cara del boxeo, le doy todo el crédito del mundo a Jaime. Y Canelo hizo una buena pelea, si no hay que quitarle nada. Yo siempre he respetado a Canelo adentro del planeta, pero yo siempre he dicho que es un buen peleador. Y lo hizo muy bien, pero Jaime es el comienzo de Jaime. Con la experiencia que va a recibir con esta pelea, ¿no? Es el comienzo para Jaime.
Así es.
Como le dije, I thought Jaime did excellent against the current face of boxing right now. I strongly feel that I take nothing away from Canelo. I've always said he's a good fighter in the ring. But this experience for Jaime will just take him to another level. It's just like Mayweather and Canelo. Same thing. You know, Canelo got schooled and then he became the face of boxing. He became a good fighter. Same thing with Munguia. He gains experience. He didn't get schooled, but he gains experience and he becomes a better fighter. So this is just the beginning for Jaime.
All right, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, Ben. Any final comments to fans that watch and are looking for you? Los Valles.
Bueno, nada más decirles a todos, muchas gracias por su apoyo y espero que hayan disfrutado la pelea. Vamos a seguir trabajando duro para seguir en el plato, brindando buenas peleas. Viva México. Muchas gracias.
Stay tuned,
Canelo
Alvarez is on his way shortly. Thank you.
Thank you.